Hey guys, you see that black line running straight up from the electrode across the top of the ceramic insulator? It runs all the way down to earth, and that's a carbon track where the high voltage has tracked down the ceramic to earth. And there's another one there. You see that one there? Running straight up there now. That's what a fouled plug looks like. So what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to try to clean up that ceramic and get rid of it, because it can just burn its way in, and then the plug is knackered. I mean, it might be knackered anyway. But I'm going to try and clean it up, and sort of nip it in the bud. But if it runs down there too much, then it sort of just burns its way into the ceramics and insulator, and then that's it. All right. Okay. So you can see it's cleaned up now. And it's some stains still there, but I'm hoping that might have done it. So we're back to white ceramic, it's only whitish. And how I did it. Yeah, so the first thing I did was I blasted it with a butane torch, and did it for, I was holding it in mole grips, and this is just to burn off any of the sticky deposits and to burn the carbon a bit, so that we can break it off easier, you know, without it being gooey or anything like this. And obviously when it had cooled down, simply took a small screwdriver and, using the flat, carefully just scraped around the top. You can see how you could just gradually work your way around, and so we can clean it all off from there, and then down the side as much as you can with that. And and then I wanted to break up the deposit, and so I used a very fine jeweler's file like this, just supporting it with the finger, and then just gradually just moving it round the ceramic all the way around, roughing it up. And that way then I could take this oven, whatever it is, it's oven cleaner, fire cleaner, and it's got corrosives, it's got warnings on the back. I don't know exactly what it's made up from, and just trickle it in. It's meant to froth up so that it sticks on the oven. And then taking a toothbrush, you can get down the side of the ceramic, and because you've sort of roughed it up, this can bite into, it cuts into the deposit so much easier, and instead of sort of burning its way through from the top, it can come in from all sides and underneath. And you just keep doing that, and then just add a touch more. And keep doing that for a couple of minutes. When you get sick of it, rinse off with water. Let's have a look. And that cleans it all off from the steel and from the ceramic. It seems to come off the steel easy, probably because it doesn't get such a good key as it can get into the ceramic. But the ceramic's the key. I mean, you want it off everything, really, but if you can get it off the ceramic, then that's great. And yeah, rinse off with water, then blow out and dry it off. And yeah, well, we'll see whether or not the spark plug can be saved, but I'm going to run it now, and hopefully that's going to be as good as new, but we're going to find out soon. Okay, so here it is after running it, and I ran it actually with, for the first time, with acetone in the petrol mix, and it's an amazing additive, is acetone. Gives you an immediate performance boost. The engine runs so much better, and that's looking lovely. I don't think I've ever had such a nice clean burn as that. So the plug's saved, and yeah, plug saved, and we've tested acetone in the petrol, and it's a hell of a boost. I'm going to do I'll do a video on the acetone anyway, but that wraps up the plug. The plug is saved. All right, guys, see you later.